Hello there, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Book of Unwritten Tales 2, Blind. We've made our way to the floating fortress, city, what have you. Is that someone kneeling there? Oh, that's a statue, isn't it? I know Nate and Crit are up here. I think. Yeah, this is before they left. Unless this is another boat. Hopefully you guys have been keeping up. It's been a while since we've been here. Last thing we saw was Nate used actually summoned forth a genie to help with the ship, and everything went bad. So I don't know. That's when he started falling through the air, like we saw in the beginning of the game. Let's look at Buttercup. She's our, you know, my little hippogriff.
Buttercup bravely fought her way through the winds on the way here. Now she's exhausted. She's earned a little downtime.
I'm surprised she can fly all the way up here. Carrying somebody.
Haven't a clue what happened to the jetty. Perhaps there was some kind of attack, or the thing just collapsed due to old age. Haven't a clue, perhaps?
Oh, snails?
Strange. Why are water snails stuck to the jetty here? Perhaps they thought, it's a jetty, and every jetty must have snails, whether it's standing in water or hanging in midair.
Yeah, pretty much.
I know these snails. They're called purple snails.
Purple
they
snails.
They emit a smelly substance to defend themselves, which turns purple in air.
Purple in air.
It's used as a dye for colouring things.
Well, you have a lot to say about them. How about we take one?
I better leave the snails in peace. I don't want to get purple fingers.
I want you to take it.
I better leave.
You'd see the abyss? Is the abyss going to look back at you?
I wouldn't like to fall down there.
She looks a little more pregnant this time. I mean, before she barely had any discernible tummy at all, and people calling her fat, and I'm like, where?
I wonder what exactly brought the Oracle to a place like this. A flying island full of pirates. Not the safest place to reveal some hard truths. A flying ship. Just as one would expect on a flying pirate island. I could swear. Oh no, is that the Mary?
Mm-hmm.
That means... Oh, no.
That's right. It's hard for me to remember, guys. It's been, like, almost a month since I played this. Starting from episode 31 to now, which I believe we're at 36 right now. This is, like, a month after when I played 1 through 30. And during that time, I was trying to get caught up with Lunar Eternal Blue. Which is a freaking nightmare for editing. I'm not going to go into that. Yeah, I know he brought forth this genie, and the genie is incompetent and afraid of using his powers.
If the Mary's here, then he can't be far away.
He.
Seeing him is the last thing I need right now.
I'm not sure, but I thought he was fell down there.
If the Mary's... See...
Anything else to look at? The Mary, the broken jetty. Oh, we got a frying pan. Something that we actually can't take. And let's take this then. Or look at it.
A pretty battered pan. Looks like it survived an explosion.
Taketh.
There are crusty bits of salt left inside there.
Right. The salt that Critter used to make, was it, well, at first he made a potion called a Glug Glug X, or that's what he called it. It was a, what do you call it? A hangover healer to wake Nate up. And I think after that he made another potion. Sorry, it's hard for me to remember right now, guys.
Sea salt. Enough for 10 tasty elf dishes, or one pirate dish.
Oh, we've got separate components.
The pan might be pretty battered, but it's okay.
I'm sure the pan doesn't feel that way about it. Here, put on your fisherwoman hat.
What's going on there, then?
Furthermore, you stole the prosecutor's fez, beat him unconscious, and damaged part of the island with magic.
We didn't beat that stupid monkey unconscious. He knocked himself out.
Silence in court.
This is a court?
The defendant may only speak when asked to do so. And don't call the prosecutor a monkey.
He is a monkey. You gonna kick him in the butt?
May I inquire what's going on here?
Ivo?
Lovely to see you again, Critter.
He just came right, he just extracted himself. Critter?
Who's that?
Oh, shut the grog up! This is a trial, not a bloody circus.
He puts his head back in. I'm going to ask again, what is going on here?
Let me ask again. What's going on here?
Critter and I were arrested for no reason whatsoever.
Uh-huh.
I wasn't talking to you.
Idiots. Those two tried to steal my magic lamp, and they damaged the island. They also abused my friendship, and wanted to leave me here on my own, like everyone else.
Guess who has abandonment issues?
Renowned for it.
Uh-huh.
Ah, enough.
Two people with
those
abandonment
two
issues
will be judged fairly and squarely.
Then I demand a lawyer.
Silence in court, you spawny wazzock.
Spawny wazzock? The hell's a spawny wazzock? You are the Red Pirate, I presume?
The Red Pirate, I presume.
You've heard of me.
Nate's mentioned you several times.
Only bad things, I hope.
Mainly that you sent the bounty hunter after him because you wanted your ship back.
The Mary is not his ship. I want it from him, fair and square.
You cheated.
Keep hearing fair and square.
Of course. I just cheated better than you. Fair and square.
Silence in court, you spawny wazzock.
You've said that before.
And that's contempt of court.
I'm searching for an oracle.
Apparently there's a near omniscient oracle on this island.
That's right. The people who aren't from here usually talk to him through mirrors.
Just guessing, but is it in that round building over there?
That's right and all. And you're not here because you want to steal from me. Or to rescue your friends.
No, definitely not.
We don't even want to be rescued.
Well, rescue Critter. I'll let you boys continue on playing on your own.
You boys just carry on playing on your own.
Now listen here, young lady. This is a matter of death. Or a more painful, slower death.
Well, not her death.
Come on, Ivo. I can barely feel my hands anymore.
Don't you dare. You left without so much as a word. You human.
Well, that's an insult.
Perhaps you'd like to be the prosecutor instead, me dear?
Oh, don't tempt her.
What is that?
It's not what it looks like.
Have you swallowed a watermelon?
Okay, now kick him in the butt.
Right, I'm pregnant. But I have not.
No sooner am I gone than you're all over the next guy that comes along.
I haven't been all over anyone.
Way to assume.
And you just scarpered off.
Scarpered?
But just because I'm not pregnant.
No kidding.
Just leave me alone, Nate Bonnet. I don't want anything to do with you anymore.
Sound like Mazaz there.
Quiet. Defendants are only allowed to cry out in despair when required.
Is that what you call it? Well, we've got plenty to look at and do. Let's look at everything before we talk to anybody. Let's look at the rope.
A rope. I bet it's good quality. Pirates know about that sort of thing.
I love this game. Take the rope.
A solid rope. Not brand new, but one could still hang a deserter with it.
Yeah. We have no reason to attach it to anything. Just look at the board.
Pictures of ships, pictures of women with malfunctioning clothes, and a petition. Nothing much of interest here.
Look at the building.
Nate often spoke of this island. He spent his childhood in New Old Town, but it was always his ambition to come here.
New Old Town?
Tugator, the Flying Pirate Island. It was the place where a boy from the streets could make something of himself. For all I care, he can spend the rest of his life on this rock.
Yeah, I never actually thought they should get together. Is she gonna run up in here and look at it? They always get climb those stairs way before that. You see how quick that is?
A rag shop. I really don't like fussy clothes like the ones Mother always tried to make me wear, but I couldn't go this far. There must be some kind of middle ground, surely. Headscarves for bald pirates, swashbuckling patches, ripped rope for a belt. No, I can't be doing with any of this. Wait a minute, what's this? A hook could come in handy.
Okay.
A hook. A replacement hand for an unfortunate pirate.
Pirates.
It's got a cuff to attach it to an arm.
Pirate's replacement hand, hook shaped. Let's knot it onto the rope.
I should be able to attach the hook to the rope.
I knew we'd want to do that.
Right, that'll hold.
Cool.
I've securely knotted the hook to the end of the rope. That'll hold.
And we have no reason to attach that any further to anything else. Statue.
No pirates to be seen. Just these stone figures everywhere. There are no traces of any tool marks on them. The surfaces are too perfect. I don't like the look of this.
It's like they've turned into stone.
Okay.
Let's look at these doors.
The door's locked. I don't believe I can break the door open. And even if I could, the red pirate would probably set his hairy thugs on me.
I don't think there's anyone here but that monkey. Let's look at the water trough, where Nate slept it off for a while, the beginning of the game. Or near the beginning of the game.
The little bit of water remaining in the trough looks very dirty, like a pig's been wallowing in it.
It was me!
She's not surprised.
Then I'll leave it to you for the punchline.
Ba-dum-psh.
The water's pretty dirty. Looks like the trough hasn't been cleaned in a while. The water...
Let's look at the plants, for some reason.
Pirates don't have much of an eye for beauty. They are, however, very practical. Everything that pirates might want is growing here, from potatoes to hemp plants. A house with no corners. Got to be it.
Right. Don't go in yet. I'm not done out here. I'm not done out here. Let me get back down there first before she does anything else. We can take some of these plants.
I'm not hungry, amazingly. And I don't want to plait a hemp rope either.
Just take them. You never know when you need them.
I'm not hungry.
Oh, God. Look at the cloth.
Something round under a cloth. It's moving.
Oh, that?
I wonder what's under that cloth there.
It's the horror. The horror.
The horror.
Old Red won't spill the beans. Guards that thing as if it was his biggest treasure.
A deserted island that should be swarming with pirates. A few stone statues, the only survivors a collector of magical artifacts, hiding something the size of a head under a cloth.
It's a Medusa head?
Let me guess. The head of Medusa?
Aye. She's dreadful.
Cool.
I knew that. I was just testing you.
Well, Wilbur has a mirror. He's not with us.
The head of Medusa is a dangerous weapon. Whole armies were stopped with it. I'd feel much happier if it wasn't in the ownership of an unstable pirate. Nate talked a lot about his old nemesis, the Red Pirate. One of Old Red's bounty hunters must have got hold of him. I mean, not even Nate would be stupid enough to come here of his own free will.
Yeah, he heard that. Let's look at the monkey.
The prosecutor would appear to be a bit out of his depth with the trial. At least he doesn't give me the impression of being particularly professional. If there was a jury, the prosecutor would need only to put me in the witness box for a minute. That would ensure that Nate would get no mercy.
Yeah,
leaving a pregnant young woman in the lurch with no explanation, not something that makes a defendant look good.
Oh, there's a key here. We take.
I guess this key will unlock the stocks. If I was planning to set them free, I'd be interested.
Well, the only one who's really held in prison there is Nate.
Even if I wanted to, I couldn't take the key with the Red Pirate sitting there.
Distract him.
I guess this key will unlock the stocks. If I was planning to set them free.
Alright, let's talk to Critter first. Because I missed Critter. Well, let's look at Critter first.
I'm not cross with Critter. He did disappear without a word, like Nate, but he belongs to Nate.
He belongs to no one.
Where Nate is where you'll find Critter. For example, in the stocks in a trial.
Yeah. Critter belongs to Critter.
Critter'll be all right. Won't matter what the outcome. He's a clever cookie and he'll probably save Nate.
Sorry about that. I had an itch on my ear. I am from the Critter Liberation Front.
Critter will be all right. Won't matter.
Useless prisoner.
He didn't even hear me out. He simply disappears, he gets involved with some dodgy deal or other, and then he tries to make me feel guilty.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to bail him out. Let Critter help him.
Right.
He didn't even hear me out. He simply disappears.
Okay. The only thing left to do around here is to talk to the Red Pirate.
Excuse me, Your Honor, Judge?
Yes.
Huh. You're a judge and you cheated in a card game?
A judge cheating at cards? Tut tut.
Tut tut.
That's not true. Pirate poker is a dice game.
So you cheated in dice?
I don't cheat. In the past, maybe. But this is the new Tugator. It's all about law and order now.
A pirate being about law and order? What are the stakes in pirate poker?
In pirate poker, you play for high stakes, right? I mean, if we play and I win, then you owe me something.
We're going
right?
to end up playing this, aren't we?
Theoretically. In reality, however, I will win. And you will owe me something.
So you say.
What, for example?
If I win, then you have to stay on Tugator for a year and keep me company.
Not worth it.
Ugh. And what if I win?
How about
your best friend's life?
No. I'd prefer something real I can hold on to.
Oh, burn.
An elegant pirate outfit. Clothes and a hat and all the trimmings.
That sounds good. Agreed.
Huh. All right, then. Explain the rules of pirate poker.
So what are the rules?
The easiest way to explain it is by playing a practice round.
Uh-huh. She really is pregnant, wow.
We each have got a cup with 5 dice. The dice have the numbers 1 to 5 on them. The 6th side is a star that can be any number, like a joker. Roll.
But this is just a practice game, right?
Aye, this game doesn't count.
Unless he wins.
Like in normal poker dice, you can throw a pair, 2 pairs, 3 of a kind, a full house, a straight, and so on.
Okay, got it.
I've got a full house. Do you believe me?
Of course not. You're a pirate.
Not so fast. If I lift up my cup and I haven't lied, you've lost. So think about it. Am I telling the truth?
I believe you, I don't believe you. You know, say what you will about the Red Pirate, but he's the only one who hasn't made fun of her belly. I don't believe you.
You're lying.
Bad luck, I wasn't lying. You would have lost. But let's just pretend that didn't happen.
Oh, how sporting of you.
Now you have to tell me what you've rolled. You can tell me the truth or lie. The most important thing is you say something higher than me. You can also pick up any number of dice and roll them again, just once, before you tell me what you've got on the table. So, put the dice in the cup and roll again, or tell me what you've got. What's it gonna be?
I don't know anything about poker, guys, seriously. What if we have all stars, though? That would be good, wouldn't it? I'm not even sure. But I don't think this is a very good hand. Can we roll this one again? Select die. Reroll. Oh, click that. Reroll. Oh, look at that. So what's better, 3 of a kind, or what he has? Didn't he say he had a full house? So is this like in order? Pair, 2 pairs, 3 of a kind, straight, full house, 4, 5 of a kind? If this is in order, then 4 of a kind is better. Let's just tell him 4 of a kind, even though we actually have 3. We can't even choose that, because it's... Yeah. He is a full house, so these aren't even as good.
4 of a kind.
I believe you.
So do we win, then?
Got 5 of a kind. Do you believe me?
I don't believe you.
I wasn't lying. So sadly, you lose, princess.
That was just a test round. I'll win when it's for real.
See those stones? You get 1 for each round you win. The first to have 3 is the winner. Ready to roll?
Oh boy. Let's play.
Fancy a game of pirate poker?
Always. Got a straight. Do you believe me?
Yeah, I believe you.
I believe you.
All right then. Roll again or tell me what you've got.
So straight isn't that good, right? We have 3 of a kind. What's better? I don't know, poker guys. Let's re-roll that one. There's a straight. So right now we have 3 of a kind. Let's tell him again. I got four of a kind.
Four of a kind.
I believe you. Got five of a kind. Do you believe me?
I
believe you.
All right
then. Roll again or tell me what you've got.
I can roll again. We have two pairs. Well, three of a kind is even better. I can't choose any of these? Wait. We're stuck. No. We're completely stuck. Hold on, let me try this. Oh, I saved over the autosave? Oh, that's alright. Or did I load the game? No, I still got this stuff. Let's try it again.
Excuse me, Your Honor, Judge?
Yes.
A judge?
That and.
In part.
Theory.
Ugh.
Your best friend.
Alright. Did I load?
So what?
Let's try it again.
We each have got a cup with five dice. The dice have the numbers 1 to 5 on them. The sixth side is a star. There can be any number, like a joke.
Okay.
Roll.
This is just a practice game, right?
Aye, this game doesn't count.
Okay, it's a wild card. I didn't know that.
Like a normal poker dice, you can throw a pair, two pairs, three of a kind, a full house, a straight, and so on.
Okay, got it.
I've got a full house. Do you believe me?
Of course not. You're a pirate.
Not so fast. If I lift up my cup and I haven't lied, you've lost. So think about it. Am I telling the truth?
You could be telling the truth.
Yes, I could be. Now you have to tell me what you've rolled. You can tell me the truth or lie. The most important thing is you say something higher than me. You can also pick up any number of dice and roll them again. Just once, before you tell me what you've got on the table. So, put the dice in the cup and roll again, or tell me what you've got. What's it gonna be?
Yeah, this is not that great, so let's re-roll this. So we don't get stuck again. Well, basically we have three of a kind, since this is a wild card, but we'll tell them four.
Four of a kind.
I believe you. Got five of a kind. Do you believe me?
No.
That was beginner's luck.
Sweet.
That was skill.
As soon as for real, your nerves are going to get the better of you. See those stones? You get one for each round you win. The first one of three is the winner. Ready to roll?
Yeah, let's play.
Fancy a game of pirate poker?
Always.
All right. So this is going to be the rest of the episode, guys. That's for sure. Well, that was a little jerky.
Three of a kind. Do you believe me?
Yeah, I think I believe him. That's not hard to get. We have five. This is a stinky hand. I believe you.
I believe you.
All right, then. Roll again, or tell me what you've got.
We're rolling again. Wait. 2, 3, 4, 5. What's a straight? Is that... It's too bad I don't really know poker, guys. Let's re-roll this one. I might have a straight, I don't know. I have four in a row. Just tell me I have a full house.
That's a full house.
I believe you. I've got four of a kind.
I thought you could only re-roll once. Oh wait, you can re-roll. That was his regular roll and his second roll. Okay. I believe you.
I believe you.
All right then. Roll again, or tell me what you've got.
Let's roll this one. Yeah. You can only tell him you've got five of a kind.
I've got five of a kind.
You're lying. Oh, you lost.
Yeah.
Next game.
It's a very calm game for pirates, isn't it?
Three of a kind. Do you believe me?
Oh, look at that. This is bugged. I believe you.
I believe you.
All right, then. Roll again, or tell me what you've got.
One, two, three, and four. Roll, I don't know. Let's roll this one. One, two. Maybe I've got a straight. Is this a straight?
I've a straight.
You're lying. Oh, what a surprise. That makes me the winner.
We're gonna lose, guys.
Now you've got to stay on Tugator for a year.
What? I thought we got to play...
Yeah, whatever. He'll be waiting a long time before that happens. I didn't say Princess's word of honor.
I thought he needed three. Whoever gets three stones wins. Well, we're going to continue this next time, guys. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and a bang, bang, boogie, and don't stop the boogie.